Saturn's rings are iconic, but up close, they're less like thin rings and more like perfectly ordered zones of terror. Saturn's rings, identified by letters according to their date of discovery, are made of chunks of ice and rock with pieces ranging in size from a grain of sand to a house, which means the rings aren't as thin as we make them out to be in our grade school models of the solar system. If you've ever seen Saturn through a telescope and the rings seem to disappear, it's just because you're seeing them head-on from about 746 million miles away, and they're relatively thin compared to Saturn. At various points, the rings range from between 30 to 300 feet thick, while Saturn's diameter is around the order of 72,000 miles. But if you look at a picture of Saturn from above, you can see that the rings have a massive diameter, which makes sense because they circle around the planet's equator. The rings combined stretch 175,000 miles from Saturn, and they aren't totally solid. Each ring is made up of multiple rings that you can see close up. As for their origin, astronomers think they're related to Saturn's 60 or more moons. Asteroids and meteoroids sometimes crash into the smaller moons, breaking them apart and adding material to the rings. But some of the material might be left over from when Saturn formed, material that never became a moon. Some moons also play a vital part in keeping the rings distinct. The rings aren't static. They orbit around Saturn like its moons do, and at least two moons around the narrow F ring keep it in check. The gravity from Pandora stops the F ring from spreading outwards, while Prometheus prevents it from spreading inwards. Other shepherd moons keep other rings in check and constrain how they spread out. They're also responsible for some odd structures. Some rings have features called propellers, spaces caused by tiny moonlets that open gaps. Other rings have spoke-looking things that are caused by conglomerations of tiny ice particles that rise above the ring's surface by electrostatic charge. So next time you're looking at Saturn, keep in mind that the rings aren't just pretty, they're little chunks of ice and rock in constant change, chaotically hurtling through space. Isn't it more fun to imagine it that way anyways? If you're a total space nut, why not start your own website cataloging your favorite planetary facts? When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 20% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Want more science in your day? Subscribe to Seeker for all the latest videos. And speaking of Saturn's moons, Julian talks about the potential for life on Enceladus right here. And my favorite fun fact, Saturn's rings are super cold. They can get down to minus 334 degrees Fahrenheit on the unlit side.